It seems now more certain than ever that the bloody experience of Vietnam is to end in a stalemate. This summer's almost certain standoff will either end in real give and take negotiations or terrible escalation. Thank you.
Oh, that's a pretty fine. I wonder if anybody's home. Remember, you just had them. You were the one driving the car.
Those were the keys to your car, silly.
I think you gave them to your other boyfriend to use.
No. Now, I know that could have happened because he gave them back to me before you left this morning.
You're a bad girl.
Easy there. I think someone's had one too many to drink tonight.
Yeah? You. When did we get on the merry-go-round? Oh,
there you go, birthday boy. All right, you wait right here. I've got a big surprise for you.
I got a surprise for you.
Bad boy, I'll be back in a minute.
Say, Steph, did you put me up to this?
Well, with a little help from your mother, we thought...
What? Bring me here and make a fool out of me in front of all my family and friends? Thanks, but no thanks.
I was just trying to throw you the surprise.
Jason, Stephanie worked hard to put this birthday together for you.
You probably gave her the whole idea.
No one told you to get drunk. You shouldn't even be.
I can see clearly now. You wanted this to happen.
I don't know what you're talking about.
This is just a big joke to you. This is just a big joke to all of you. You don't have to worry about me. I'm not going to be the center of your jokes.
Now you've clearly had too much to drink.
Don't you lecture me on responsibleness or how I'm supposed to act. You're the one with all your clothes on.
Jay, where are you going?
Like any of you care.
Stephanie, let him calm down. He needs a minute to cool off.
You still got to eat cake?
I know you'll make the Marine Corps and your country proud. It is now up to you to keep the freedom that our forefathers fought to create. It is in this memory of those who have fought and given their lives for our country that I will now pass the torch on to you. This mission will not be easy. Fight the good fight. Semper Fi, Marines.
Hey, Marine. Here's your order, son. Try to do us proud. Stay alive.
Morning, Sergeant.
Good morning, Chipbird.
Dollar waiting on a dime here.
Yeah. All right. Over here. Hello and welcome to Vietnam, home of the number one GI, the slant eye. Getting high, do or die, listen to my battle cry, fix your sleeves. Drink and fight, screw all night.
Huh? See?
First of all, Lance Corporal, I know them girls in town ain't that good.
Sorry, sir. Yeah.
There you go. What's your name, son?
EZFNG, sir. I mean, new member from Alpha Platoon. Sir,
yeah,
sir.
Yeah. I think he can speak for himself, Tanachi.
Yes, sir.
Edmund, sir. Jason Edmund.
Edmund, where's home, Edmund?
Omaha, Nebraska, sir.
Omaha, Nebraska. Well, ain't no cornfields here, son. Closest you get to corn here is on the bottom of them feet of yours. You sit around here trying to watch something grow. You're bound to get your ass shot off.
Sir, yes, sir.
All right. You boys have a good day now.
Oh, and Private Edmund.
Yes, sir.
I'd stay clear of any women that Lance Corporal Tanachi here has had relations with, if you know what's good for you.
Yes, sir. I'll keep that in mind, sir.
Thank you, sir. And, Mama-san says you still owe her from last week. Let's go, let's go. This thing doesn't always start like that, so, you know, patience.
Woo!
First, I know some nice girls who got a thing for FNGs. Boy, what they would not do to you! It's right up here if you want to go, man. It's...
Actually, I'm kind of hungry.
All right. AMC. Ah, I know. You ever had yourself a traditional Vietnamese meal before? If you haven't, you got to try it at least once.
Whatever works sounds good to me. I'm so hungry I can eat a water buffalo.
Actually, not that good eating. Over here, nothing seems to taste like chicken.
Aloha.
That means hello. You're gonna love this place, Jay. It's the best food in town. Two beers? Hey, before you go off and embarrass yourself, I feel like there's a couple rules of etiquette that you need to know about.
Like what?
Thank you. Well. Vietnamese are a very proud people. They give you the shirt right off the back if it make you happy. So, when you're enjoying a traditional Vietnamese meal, the best way for you to show that you enjoy the food is for you to toss a plate out the window after you're done eating.
What, are you kidding me?
Hey, shh. Just keep it down. If you act like a tourist, they're gonna treat you like a tourist. And tourists don't get treated very well around here, alright? So just follow my lead. You know, let's just have the usual. Some of those famous noodles. I love her.
So the lights come on. There's my family and my friends standing there watching me. I'm naked on the couch. My soldier's at full attention.
So what'd you do?
Next day I joined the Marine Corps. Here I am.
Okay, so wait a minute. You mean to tell me that you haven't phoned home or written anybody in your family since that night?
Well, my parents know that I joined the military. Uh-huh. They've been trying to write me a few letters. I just mark them return to sender.
Oh, that is good. Hey, I'm sorry, man. I think anybody would suffer performance anxiety after a show like that.
I don't have any problems in that department.
Oh, well... You'll get your chance to prove it tonight.
You'll finish, Henry Jesus.
Yes, thank you. You know, I don't know how you do it, but it just gets harder and harder to leave every time I come in.
Must keep you strong. Strong to fight. Keep you safe. Keep you safe.
Oh, anything for you, sweetheart. Hey. You tell your mother I said thank you, okay?
Thank you. You come back soon.
Absolutely. Stand by. Okay.
this is where you've been hiding out. You know that cute one in the little pink dress? She keeps asking about you.
Yeah, right.
No, really, I told her that you weren't interested in that you preferred a nice, big, fat, hairy leg.
What? You son of a
bitch. I'm just kidding, man. She digs you. Besides, I told her I didn't know where you were. You can't sit in here by yourself in the dark like this. It's not good for you. If you just sit in here and think about home, the time in the jungle is going to take forever. The secret? You got to stay busy. I know this cool little place down the road to help take your mind off home for a bit.
I don't have enough money for that place.
It's not like that. Get your mind out of the gutter. Come on. Grab your jacket. Let's go. So you've been in Vietnam this long, you haven't had a traditional Vietnamese meal before? Well, let me just start by saying, this is the best food in Vietnam. I ate here the first time it came to us.
Mmm, that hit the spot.
You just wait till the food gets here. David introduced me to this place. This place is so traditional, they still believe in customary plate tossing.
What's that?
Well, came on.
What'd you just say to her?
I just said thank you. If you learn their language, they'll let you into their culture. If you act like a tourist, they're gonna treat you like a tourist.
So what'd you say we do now?
Allow me to demonstrate. There you go. You sure you haven't done this before?
Whew, I like this custom. Are you sure we're not gonna get in trouble for this?
Get in trouble? It's their custom. Besides, when in Rome?
What?
You know the saying.
I've never been to Rome.
Oh, well, never mind. Besides, you need to work on that plate tossing. My little sister has more accuracy than you do, and she's only two. Ridiculous.
Yeah,
that's right, man. We're mean, green eating machines. Would you marry me?
Alright, we'll take the check now. Stu, you can come back for your wife tomorrow. Looks like it's about to rain. We should probably get heading. Why is this bill so expensive?
Well, the plates, you toss them out.
What do you mean? What about the custom?
No, silly. There's no custom for the plates.
Damn it. Let's get out of here. Son of a bitch, David. Come on, Stu, let's go.
Can we just wait a minute? I want to talk with my future wife.
You get your ugly ass up and let's go.
Boy, you sure know how to pull the fun.
I thought you and I were friends!
I'm sorry, man. Would you get a look at those beauties?
What the hell did you do that for?
You fucking set me up!
What are you talking about?
I thought you were different. I thought I could trust you.
Oh, I know what this is about. Hey, man, I didn't know you had a thing for Hong Mai. Look, you were out in the field and we got a little crazy, but it's no big deal.
No, you son of a bitch! Does plate tossing ring any bells and it shit for brains, head ears?
No, you didn't. You took Stu to the restaurant? Plate tossing? Man, this is good. But never in a million years did I think that you would remember that. I'm sorry. This is just too funny.
I'm glad you think it's so funny. I don't know how I could let myself believe that someone like you knew anything about culture.
You were an FNG, Jay. Coming off the back of that plane, looking like you were straight off your mama's titty.
Fuck you. You were supposed to be my best friend.
Hey, take it easy. Alright, it was just a joke.
Yeah, maybe to you. But that was a test. And you failed.
No.
Starting tomorrow, I'm asking to be transferred to Charlie Platoon.
Are you serious? It was because of a little joke?
I don't have anything else to say to you.
You know what? You take things way too personal, Jay. tell you what, you calm down a little bit. When you're ready, I'm gonna be down at the New York bar. Those pages better not be sticking together when I get back, Stu. Hey. Hey. Don't take too long either, all right? Beers don't taste so good when they get warm.
Woo! This honey sure knows how to carry it. I think I'm in love.
Yeah. trying everything. Your heaven's trying everything to break me down.
Evelyn?
Thank you for squeezing me in, Dr. McKenna.
Well, good to see you today. I'm sorry, the best I could offer you is just 15 minutes before my noon session, but you said it was urgent. So what's the...
I just voted.
Oh, well, I'm really proud of you, Evelyn. I don't recall you voting during the 7 years you've been coming here. How do you feel?
I feel a little stressed. What is that? Oh,
I apologize. My wife and I just had our 25th anniversary. It's her way of commemorating that our love has passed the test of time. But lately it just reminds me of how annoying she is. Just ignore it. I'm sure that you won't even know it's there after a while. Like her numbing, nagging voice. I'm sorry, you were saying that you feel a little stressed?
Yes, a little, but we're fine.
Evelyn, what's the situation with your meds?
Well, the meds make me really tired, and I didn't want anything or anyone to stop me from getting to the polls. This is a historic election year.
So you skipped your meds today?
Yes, and yesterday, and the day before that, and I think...
Evelyn, we've been through this. It's
absolutely imperative that I take my meds every day to control my episodes and to be a viable part of society. I know, but that's not the problem.
Okay, then why the emergency session?
Because I need your help. I'd like you to hypnotize me so that I can remember who I voted for.
Well, I'm sorry, Evelyn, but I'm not a trained hypnotist.
Come on, it can't be that hard. I've seen it on TV.
Well, I can't just wave a watch in front of your face, tell you to count to 10, give you instructions.
And then I wake up and tell you who I voted for.
There's no guarantee that that'll work. And a myriad of issues or personalities could surface. It's too risky.
No. Living with all this confusion inside of me, that's risky. Dr. McKenna, I am walking around with an I voted sticker on. I don't even know who I voted for. Do you know what it's like to have a war going on inside of you? Fighting between taking a risk or being safe, following your heart or following your head, it's too much. I just want to be able to concentrate long enough to hear my own thoughts. If I didn't vote, if one of them voted, then I don't count. And I don't matter. And I need to know that I matter. Will you please help me?
I'll try, Evelyn. But I make no promises.
Okay.
Okay, Evelyn. Just sit back and relax. And watch the dream catcher. You are relaxed and safe and peaceful. Yeah. Now I want you to count backwards slowly from 10.
10. 9.
You're getting sleepier.
8.
And sleepier.
7.
Sleepier, and now you are completely asleep. Good. Now, Evelyn, in a moment, I'm going to snap my fingers, and when I do, you will wake up and you will remember everything that happened this morning. Damn that clock.
Did it work?
Well, I don't know. Do you feel anything? That's okay. Let's just try it the old-fashioned way. Let's talk through your day.
Okay. Well, when I got to the polls, I had already decided that I was going to vote for Hillary Clinton.
Oh, but she wasn't on the ballot.
Oh, I know. I was just going to write her name.
Oh, well, Evelyn, that's not how it works. Excuse me. I can't seem to figure out how to turn it off. So you wrote in Clinton.
Oh, Evelyn doesn't understand political protocol, Dr. McKenna. Things of such nature are better left for adults like you and I.
Annabelle.
I'm glad you recognize a woman of substance and sophistication like myself.
Well, of course, Annabelle. How could I not recognize you?
Charmed.
Yes. So Evelyn would like to know for whom you voted.
I'm sure she would. You can tell Miss Evelyn that we voted for the best man for the job. Senator John McCain. He's inspiring and strong, wise and confident. Ooh, and with all his service to our country, why, it's quite romantic. He's such a gentleman. What a place. I could see myself marrying a man like him. And then I thought to myself, if I, Annabelle Lee Rosemary Saffron Martinez St. Jacques Jackson, could see myself marrying a man like McCain, then why couldn't I see myself voting for him? Why, it'd kind of be like marrying the president, which of course would make me the first lady.
I thought you said you'd never get married.
Oh, no, that was Evelyn. That's what she said. But as God as my witness, I'm gonna find her husband. Every woman worth her salt needs a man. I want a man. And what better man than John McCain? Oh, yes. All I can think about is having that sexy, white, chocolate in my Oval office. Oh, yes. Oh, oh, yay. Are you still with that wife of yours?
Annabelle, this is most inappropriate.
Dear Dr. McCain, now whatever happened to doctor, patient, confidentiality? I won't tell if you won't.
I think you should just sit down and we should get back to talking about your voting experience.
Fine. So when I got to the polls, the line was unacceptably long for a lady of my status. So I cornered one of the volunteers and asked if I could get priority voting. I told him how hot and faint I felt. Oh, have mercy on my body!
Evelyn?
Oh, yes?
Annabelle.
Take me!
Whoever you are, this is totally unacceptable.
Oh! Oh,
I'm so sorry. It's just so warm in here.
Just like a white man trying to keep a sister down. What is this, the 60s?
Dominique?
Hell yeah. And the last thing I need is a hand from the man.
Fair enough. Evelyn wants to know who you voted for.
Who did I vote for? Who did you vote for? Are you making decisions on your own yet, or is that wife of yours still pushing you around? It's time for a change, Dr. McKenna. It's time to take a stand. Fight for what you believe in. Barack Obama said it's time for a change.
Yes. Yes, it is. Does that mean you voted for Obama?
Don't rush me. You see, the media's trying to label us as a double minority, using Hillary and Barack to split the votes. But ain't no divide and conquer here. You see, the people united will never be defeated.
So you voted for
Obama! But obviously, the man was plotting against me. Because when I finally got my chance behind that curtain of injustice and prepared to pierce my selection, I realized the stylist was missing. It was a conspiracy. Just like Florida.
So you weren't able to vote?
Oh, free at last, free at last. If you interrupt me one more time, I'm gonna dropkick your ass. As I was saying. So I reached in my bag and pulled out this pick and used one of the prongs to punch my choice. Ooh! I felt so liberated. I felt so free. I had to vote again. Yes, we can! 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 Yes, we can!
Evelyn?
What happened?
We had a breakthrough.
So who did I vote for?
Well, I'm not sure, Evelyn. But it's not about who you voted for. It's the fact that you had the audacity to vote, all of you. You took charge of your life. Your vote counts. You matter.
The audacity to vote. Yeah. Did you hear that? We matter. Oh, I take it our 15 minutes are up. Thanks again, Dr. McKinnon.
Not a problem. Oh, and Evelyn?
I know. Take my meds. We promise.
Oh, actually, I was going to suggest that you take the girls out to lunch.
Yeah, I think they like that. Although Annabelle's a vegetarian and Dominique loves her pork. We'll work it out. See you next week.
I'm making this video to warn you. I don't think we're gonna make it out of this alive. So to prove that we aren't some crazy religious cult some news portrays us to be, I wanna tell you our side of the story.
Let me out! Let me out of here!
3 weeks ago, I moved into this house with my fiance and my brother.
Damn, maybe your shit is fucking heavy.
It's not my shit. It's that dumb cabron Aiden's.
For real? Fuck that shit. Slavery ended years ago.
Why is my box on the floor like that?
I don't know. Do I look like a detective?
Are you fucking serious? You're seriously gonna be living with that asshole?
Dude, keep quiet. Don't let Denise hear you.
What? Marcos is a total prick.
What did he do this time?
Nothing you should worry about. Cito?
And watch what you say about my brother.
Yeah, whatever.
Did you see the room yet?
No.
Come with me.
You ready?
Yeah. I like this one.
Well, and this one it is.
I love it.
By the way, I got you something.
What? What did you?
I know I promised to get a real engagement ring.
Denise Marie Crespo, will you do me the honor of being my wife and letting me take care of you forever and ever?
Yes.
I love you.
I met Aiden during pledge week at school. Him and Christian were running down the street naked when Aiden ran into me. Not exactly love at first sight, but that's how it happened. Marcos isn't too fond of that story. I love you so much.
Hey, I'm not carrying the rest of your shit in by myself. Fine.
Be a real ass sometimes, you know that?
You wouldn't have it any other way.
Put these in the closet. Marcos and Aiden never got along, mostly because Marcos is such a hothead. The thing is, he's the only family I got left. After my parents died, he raised me. I love my brother.
Yo, Denise! You cooked dinner yet?
Yo, where the hell is everybody?
We'll be back later with leftovers. Don't eat too much. Love, Denise. That means you, Jamal.
Yeah, okay. And I'm gonna get me a sandwich.
Yo, you're a fat ass.
Yeah. Yo, what the fuck?
fuck was that?
What?
Yo, somebody's in here, man.
Jamal.
What are you talking about?
For real. I saw something.
Jamal!
What the fuck? I know he's in here.
There's no one in here.
Yo, I swore I saw something.
You're crazy. It's just your imagination.
Imagination, my ass.
Not really sure how all of this happened, but as time went on, we realized that there was something living in the house with us. And I told you we were moving here 2 weeks ago, so tell me why the fuck my living room has no furniture in it.
Hold up, Mr. Not Ben today, all this room is to watch TV.
I'll call you back.
Look, I don't speak Mexican. Can you please leave me alone?
I ain't Mexican!
What's going on?
This hija de puta was taking a nap and we just wanted to watch some TV.
And this dickhead threw water on me.
You better check yourself. I don't even care if you're friends with my sister. I'll still kick your ass.
Guys, come on.
Shut up. The only reason you can even afford to live in a place like this is because of Aiden. You do know that, right?
Excuse me?
You heard me.
Yo, fuck this nigga up, Marcos.
Wait, come on, no, wait, back off, Christian. Back off. Go in our room if you want to sleep. Listen, I don't need your help, white boy.
Oh, fuck you, man. I can't believe you're taking his side over mine. The hell with you. Just all you guys, I'm out of here.
Look, man, I'm sorry about Christian, right?
Yeah, whatever.
Can you check up on Christian? Please. Thank you. Child sometimes, Marcos. You know that?
Christian was mouthing off about things he didn't know and Aiden.
And Aiden was defending you.
I'm sorry. What do you want me to do?
Christian, look. It wasn't like that, okay? Chris, come on, open up.
No! No!
Just over a week ago. We've been locked in here ever since, keeping that thing from escaping. We're tired, hungry, and stressed out. And to be honest, I don't know how much we can take before.
Damn! Don't this motherfucker ever shut the hell up!
Stop talking to it, Jamal!
Thank God. I was wondering when this motherfucker was gonna take a nap.
Guys, what's going on?
I don't know, just stay back.
Knew he was faking.
Denise, it's me, Aiden. Go back in the room, Denise. Denise, you have to listen to me.
Shut up!
Go back in the room, Denise!
I'm gonna
leave! Denise,
mommy, don't come any closer! Oh, I can't hold it back forever. You have to kill me.
What?
If you
kill me now, Mom's thing controls you, will kill it. You have to trust me.
No!
It will kill you if you don't.
Ian! No, I won't let you do this!
I can take care of this thing,
if you do this, I'll know you did it forever and I'll hate you for it!
Are you fucking kidding me? I'll do it.
Oh, thanks.
Oh, shit.
Denise! 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 application error. The application has run out of memory. Now the system starts to reboot. This is tricky. Tricky disco. This is tricky. Tricky disco. This is tricky. Tricky disco. This is tricky.
No, just wait, okay? If you give me another week, I promise I can get you the money. Look, this, all I need is another week, man. Where are you going? Just stop and listen to me for just a second, okay? I know you need some help around here. I'm good with stuff.
Look, I gave you a break last month, okay? You can't come up with money. There's nothing I can do about it.
There is something you can do. You can give me more time. That's all I'm asking for. I'm asking for one more week, Mr. Perkins.
This is not a charity.
Look, you can't just throw my shit out on the street like it's trash. This is all my shit!
Hello.
Hello? Shepherd. Hi. Yeah, it's me. I kinda ran into some trouble, and I need some money.
Reality is a painful thing, ain't it?
Please listen.
Listen to what? You should have thought about that before you disrespected me and left here.
Hi, welcome to the Blue Lagoon Caribbean Soul Food Restaurant.
Can you tell me where the ladies' room is?
Yeah, it's down the hall on your left.
Thank you.
God is gonna send his angels in your time of need. You promise me you'll be open to receive them.
Excuse me, may I have the sugar dispenser, please? You look like you could use a friend. Bad day? You know, sometimes just getting it off your chest, I mean, it helps. Thanks for the sugar.
I lost my job today and was evicted from my apartment.
Oh, damn. That is a bad day. I'm Santiago. Folks call me Santi.
Jezebel. Folks call me Jesse.
Jezebel. It's a beautiful name. You know, I think she got a bad rap.
I agree. You in the business?
Well, as a matter of fact, I...
Can I get you something?
I'll have a house salad and a glass of water.
Santi, anything else for you?
No, I'm good. Thank you.
I used to dream about going in places and having people know my name.
Yeah, that's the funny thing about this town. Nobody really knows anybody here.
God forgives.
I certainly hope so. An actor.
Guilty.
I knew it.
Chasing a dream.
You know what I admire and really respect that. But let me tell you something. This bump in the road for you is gonna make a really nice anecdote on the Tonight Show. I'm telling you, your luck is gonna change. How'd you enjoy your salad?
It was good. It was great. Thank you.
I'm glad.
You know, you didn't have to do that in there.
It's no problem. You're a long way from South Carolina with no purse. And I don't know how much money you have in your bra, but whatever it is, you should probably hold on to it. Excuse me one second. Titus, hey, listen, I have a young lady I think you should meet. Yeah. I think she may be what you're looking for. Give me an hour. All right. Peace. Why don't you take a ride with me?
No. I'm sorry. Thank you for... But no,
hey, listen,
I can't just get in your car.
I understand, okay? I find talent for a group of filmmakers that can dramatically change the circumstances with the snap of their finger.
Right. So what do you want?
Okay, I get that. I'll be safe. Mm-hmm. This is my driver's license, okay? This is my business card.
Here's my phone. Call your people and tell them who you're with. Give them the plate number off my car. I just want to help you, okay? Or I can leave you here, no harm, no foul. Let's take a ride.
And the scribes and Pharisees brought unto him a woman. She is simply exquisite.
Thank you. You're very kind.
Would you turn for me, my delicate Bonita? I know the camera will love you. Santi, my good man, you never cease to amaze me with your eye for beauty.
You are doing wonders for my self-esteem.
Titus, this is Jesse. Jesse, Titus.
God smiles upon me with the blessing of you. My sweet. Care for a libation.
Now, Titus is probably the best photographer in the industry. He's also a pretty hot filmmaker.
Wow.
You know what? I think he likes you.
So you really think he'll take my picture?
I'm certain he'll insist on it.
Okay.
Wait, that wasn't good.
Oh, sensational. Yes, it was.
No, it wasn't
you
good.
You are a goddess that knows no equal.
I see you in magazines, on the cover. Beautiful. Sensational.
How do you feel?
You're a star. For your stay to be pleasant, so please don't make me behave in a less than proper fashion. It's not my best look. Are we clear? Now, do you believe in God? Good. I have this little ditty, dog-eared. It's one of my favorite. And Ruth said, entreat me not to leave thee or return from following thee. For whither thou goest, I will go, and where thou lodgest, I will lodge. Thy people shall be my people, and thy God my God.
Let me go.
In due time. But first, make sure you have a true appreciation of love.
Make the next one tall, broad shoulders, and handsome. I like the athletic type. As for this one.
Daddy?
Yes, baby.
Can I have some more love? Please?
You leave my house for that foolishness? You own your home.
Yes, beloved. Daddy got all the good loving that baby needs.
How you holding up, Santi?
Oh, I'm good. Thank you.
Okay, well, I'll come check up on you later, okay?
Appreciate it.
Excuse me, brother. I don't mean to be too forward, but may I join you?
Is that animal magnetism?
Well, actually, I was hoping you were a member of the family.
No, brother, I'm not, but I got a real appreciation for beautiful things. Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
I'm Santiago. Folks call me Santi.
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 Santi, nice to meet you. I'm Adam.
It's good to meet you, brother.
Yes.
Why don't you join me?
Thank you.
Hang on. Excuse me, Adam. I got to take this.
Here you go.
Oh, good.
Is there anything else I can help you with?
No, just some water, maybe.
Okay, I'll be right back.
Thank you. Can I help you?
I was a very different person before him. You should go.
Hello.
Daddy?
Is that you, baby girl?
Can I come home?
Thank you. So get this. My mama and my sister think I need help with my love life.
Well, it has been a long time since I've seen you with a man.
They want to set me up on blind dates, which is nothing more than humiliation and torture for me. Like always.
I think they are just trying to help.
Oh, Darlene, let me help.
You are just like my sister. Well, minus the fetus growing in her stomach, of course.
Thank God for that. We are just women of experience.
Oh, now, is that what you call being a slut and not knowing who the father of your baby is? How very progressive of you.
You wouldn't be like this if you were getting some.
Sarah Sue, now there is nothing wrong with being an independent woman who is more focused on her own career than on getting impregnated by Joe Dirt.
Darlene, you're a librarian's assistant.
Now, yes, but someday I will be head librarian at a massive library where all the books smell old because they're first editions, not because Harry fell asleep on them. And of course, there'll be an amazing movie collection with all the classics. And people will turn things in on time and in perfect condition.
Well, if you're waiting for Miss Mayberry to drop dead, I think it's gonna be a while.
True.
God, that little bugger.
You're gonna end up like her.
It's okay, my little babies.
What?
Just for you. Just for you.
Yes. No. No, I will not end up like that crazy old lady.
Think about it. She's head librarian. You want to be head librarian. She's never been married, and, well, you probably won't get married either. Stare into your future, Darlene.
May I present the new hot Darlene Harris?
Well, look at you! Is it too much? Jolene, I think it's too much. I mean, this isn't me.
Relax, he'll love it. Trust me.
You do look pretty. You know, I was starting to worry about you, Darlene. There hasn't been a man in your life for a while.
Well, I've just been busy with work.
No. Will you just hold still for a minute?
That may be true, but I was starting to think you were a lesbian.
Mama, I'm not a lesbian.
I would love you just the same.
Mama.
I think we need more cleavage.
Me too. Push him off.
Now that's enough. I'm just going on a date with a man. I'm going on a date with a man. Oh.
One iced tea of the Long Island variety. It should help you relax.
Hey, I'm Steve. You must be Darlene, Joe's sister.
Nice to meet you, Steve.
So then his wife says, "That's not my purse." Oh, dadgummit, Darlene. I'm so glad you agreed to go on the date with me.
Me too.
I'll admit I was a little scared you weren't going to show up. I mean, the fact that I could be the father of Joe's baby and everything. A little weird. But you know, if we get married, I could be that baby's daddy and his uncle. And I mean, that'd be kind of neat.
Yeah, neat.
Marcy, can I please get another one of these? Jolene Ann Harris, how could you?
Well, it's your fault. You scared me. You gotta be careful about scaring me, Darlene. I mean, next time I might accidentally pop my baby out.
Please be careful, Darlene. I don't want placenta all over my carpets.
I'm sorry that I scared you, but I do not want your whorish leftovers.
Oh, you didn't like Steve? Well, he's a sweet man with a very gentle touch. I thought you might like that, but if you want to be thrown around a bit, I do know a guy.
I'm done. I should just get a cab.
Well, I did meet this nice, handsome young man over at the corner store the other day. And I just happened to have his number. I got it for you, of course.
Winning state was the best night of my life. I still have that jockstrap I wore during the game. Never been washed, still smells like victory. Maybe a little later on I can try it on for you if you'd like.
Suddenly, I don't feel hungry anymore.
Okay.
Why, hello there.
Now, she can flirt with a man.
I can flirt. I just choose not to.
Right. And I'm the Virgin Mary.
I'm above flirting.
No woman is above flirting.
Fine, I can't flirt. I'm just not good at that kind of stuff.
First step to getting some is admitting you need help.
You mean to finding love?
Potato, potato. Basically, you just don't want to end up like that old bird, alone. And chasing insects for a living.
Wow. Please don't let that be me.
Well, you have to admit she does have skill. At least more than you. Maybe I can use that.
Sarah Sue, focus.
Sorry. You just need some adventurous, exotic guys in your life. No more boring losers. And I know just the guys.
Thanks.
Hello there. I'm John. I can feel a good vibe coming from you.
Thank you. You too.
Yeah. It's as if our auras are trying to touch. Mix together, form a bond. This table's getting in the way. Feng Shui is vital to this work. So we have to utilize...
For my aura. Gag reflex. Oh, I mean,
Wrong pipe. It went down the wrong pipe.
Hello, darling.
Oh, Dale, what are you doing here?
I got a date.
Oh, well, good for you.
Here, darling. I got these for you.
What?
Well, Sarah Sue says that we was meant to be together, and I don't dare mess with fate, so here I am.
Dale, we're cousins.
Yep. Twice removed to being fat. But Sarah Sue said, it's our destiny.
I heard the word cousin. I have been looking everywhere for you. Your mom said you weren't home, so I went to Dale's and he said things didn't go so well.
Duh.
Dale is my cousin. Oh, he did say that once. But it was in the throes of passion. I thought we were just role playing.
You and my cousin.
Yeah, a while ago, but that's ancient history. I've got great news. Are you drunk?
No, I don't get drunk. That is just iced tea, especially made by my new friend, Marcy. She would not sleep with my cousin.
That's Long Island iced tea. Come on, let's go. No, let's go. Come on, get your bag. Come on. Oh, those are pretty. Nice. All right. Nope, that stays.
Well, this is not the way I imagined telling you this, but here goes. Guess who is the new head librarian of the Stapleton Public Library?
Harry! No, Marcy, no! It's Jolene! Do I get a prize?
No, you! Miss Mayberry and Harry eloped and ran off together. He apparently had a thing for Miss Mayberry, which is why he was always in the library. Oh, and he's not homeless anymore. Some rich uncle died and he got all the money. I should have jumped on him when I had the chance. Oh.
Come on. So I'm head librarian?
Yep, you officially have your own desk.
I'm head librarian.
Come on, get in the car, Miss Head Librarian.
Oh, don't you sass the head librarian. I can take away your library card privileges.
Oh. Okay. Woo.
I didn't peg you for a sprinkles kind of guy.
Oh yeah? What kind of guy am I?
Glazed with chocolate kind of guy.
The corner store was all out. That makes you either psychic or a stalker.
Neither. I just recognize a fellow donut connoisseur when I see one.
Enjoy the movie, and your donut.
You too. I've seen this movie a million times.
Me too. But don't tell anyone. It might hurt my reputation.
Well, in that case, would you like to go get some coffee? It's great with donuts.
Frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn about seeing the ending. Shall we?
I'm Darlene.
Dave.
It's nice to meet you, Dave.
Thank you.
excuse me. Can I help you with something?
I'm sorry. I saw your car parked behind mine. It looked exactly like my first car, so I wanted to check to see if it was the same one.
How interesting. So is it your old car?
Yeah, it still has the dent for me backing up into the pole of a gas station. Granted, it has a lot more dents and scratches now, but
oh,
hey, so do
shit.
I.
Shit! Another parking ticket? God, I was like a minute late.
I'm sorry. My name is Charles. What's your name?
Alyssa.
Alyssa, that's a nice name. Nice to meet you, This is going to sound strange, Alyssa, but can I sit in your car for a minute?
Sit in my car? What for?
Seeing my old car brought back a lot of memories.
Okay, look, I think this old car thing is really cute, but I have an assignment that I need to work on that's due tomorrow.
What's your assignment?
It's for my journalism class.
What could be a better story than mine?
Do you really think people care about someone finding their old car?
If they're my age, they probably will.
It's for my college newspaper. I need to go.
It wouldn't take long and...
Okay, I just caught you breaking into my car.
I was not breaking into your car. If you want to sit with me in your car, fine.
Oh, sure. Thanks for the invitation.
Seems like yesterday, when my father brought the car home, I was 18, and we used to work on it together on weekends. Once, I even slept in the car for a few days because I got kicked out of my apartment.
That explains all the sweat stains.
What do you say, Alyssa?
Look, I don't know you. I don't even know if this really is your old car. I don't think so.
I can prove to you that this was my old car. If you check the spare tire compartment in the trunk, you'll see a signature and date on it. Me and my father signed and dated it when we finished restoring the car.
Could you?
See?
Can you put it back? That was nice. But I have work to do.
I can take care of your parking ticket.
Look.
You'll still have an interesting story to tell.
My time is worth more than $50.
I'll pay you $100 to sit in your car.
The answer is no.
$200!
I'm not renting out my car!
Then how much will you sell it for?
I'm not selling it! Look, you're a strange man, you know that?
I picked up my wife on our first date in this car. Her name was Sarah. I was so nervous, and she was so beautiful.
I'm so sorry. Please. No. I already told you I'm not renting out my car.
I was just thinking about all the people who sat next to me in the car. Most of them have passed away. My dad, my mom, my grandmother. I'm just glad me and my car are still around and got to see each other once more. And then a nice girl like you is taking care of the car.
You call that a camera? Let me take some pictures of you.
So when am I going to get my pictures, young lady?
Be patient, old man. Charles, I won't sell my car and I won't rent it, but you can sit in it whenever you miss it.
No need for that. I got what I wanted. Here's my business card.
I'll mail them to you.
Thank you, Alyssa.
Take care, Charles.